reading it. My name is Nancy Zimmerman, born and grew up here, lived for 20 years in Vancouver and returned here recently, and I own a digitally based business. There's a lot of conversation or discussion about extraction industries, and there is also reference to the need to diversify, but what was to me conspicuously absent was discussion of creative economy, green economy, digital economy. When I returned here, I was blown away to discover the Northwest Territories as a whole is what I would describe as a digital backwaters. Communities don't even have cell service, appallingly low internet speeds. This in 2011, and I would say we compare disfavorably to even the heart of China or India. So in addition to economic need for to get up to speed, literally, with bandwidth, I also wonder about some of the social issues that could be addressed with proper digital infrastructure. So I guess my question is, can we do two, or do I have to choose?
Oh, two candidates or two ridings?
Two ridings.
As long as it's kind of 4 to 5 people maximum, that's fine.
Oh boy.
You're not picking.
I want to hear from Range Lake. I want to hear from Range Lake, particularly because there are some business people there, but I haven't heard much about anything other than a particular kind of business.
Go ahead.
I'm also interested in Welladay.
Sorry, what was the question? Can you repeat that?
The question is, what would you do to get us up to speed?
And which ridings did you want? Range Lake and what was the other one?
Range Lake and ideally Welladay as well.
Welladay, okay. Go ahead. We'll start with Welladay, if you don't mind. Okay, we'll start with Range Lake. Gerald DeLady, do you mind going first? Go ahead.
Okay, thank you for your question. I don't deny the fact that we're definitely suffering in a digital age as we go from the urban centers to the communities. Lots of the issues are surrounding around the regulations of infrastructure itself and the fact that some of that infrastructure is not being used, I'll use the term fairly, for some of our other subsidiaries here in the north. So I think first and foremost, I think we've got to be very cognizant and very upfront and listen to the larger infrastructure organizations to see how we can share this technology. The technology is there. There's just a lot of roadblocks and a lot of red tape. And again, this would also benefit all aspects of the digital age, including healthcare, which is really on the brink of a new era, and we just have to make sure we give them that opportunity. So I feel your pain. I see it myself in my own business. But I think there's a lot of regulations there. There's lots of legislation there to help all businesses and technology come forward and sharing infrastructure. Right now, it's not a playing field right now.
All right. We'll go to Norm Smith next to Range Lake.
Thank you. Our communications in the north are not as good as they are down south. Frankly, that's you're right about that. And we certainly could improve on that. I think it would improve a lot. It'd help through all sorts of avenues in helping the communities throughout the North and through Yellowknife. I don't know a lot about the communication industry, but I'd certainly be willing to sit down and try and improve that because take 911, for instance. That would be something that we certainly should be looking at, and I think it's long overdue. And so, yes, I would be looking at that. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Dave Veselsky, Range Lake.
Thank you very much for the question. There's just a few parts of that are interesting. I mean, how many other capital cities in Canada can you cross the street and lose cell phone reception or go to the back of the grocery store? And if you're too close to the milk, your cell phone doesn't work. Never mind going to, you know, Good Hope or Tuck or Inuvik and having your phone being too new to work or just doesn't work. I know a lot of work's been done by the federal government to look at digital infrastructure in the north. The GNWT hasn't really addressed it and hasn't taken much of an active role in looking at digital connectivity. A lot needs to be done. I mean, right now there's a booming satellite business in Inuvik, and the satellite industry is huge, but they don't have the connectivity to actually make it happen. It's worth $15 to $20 million in revenue a year just to transmit the data. And I know the GNWT is now looking at the Valley Fiber and getting some things to happen, but it doesn't have any profile and is barely moving along. Stuff like this needs to happen. In Alberta, 10 years ago, they built SuperNet, connected all the communities, and put everybody on an even playing field. That has to happen in the Northwest Territories. The only way we're going to foster and support people in different communities and deliver education, healthcare, is proper digital connectivity.
And that's it. Thank you. Pete McKenzie of Range Lake.
Well, I know from firsthand from teachers from all across the north when they read on communications how slow it is and some of the things getting into the communities from the transaction. But there is some of the outlook that for the Mackenzie fiber link, not my uncle or related to anybody, but if that government takes a look at that, that will open up many avenues. It will open up stuff for surgery. It will open stuff for the communications. It will open up stuff for small businesses to be to have a faster impact. The South is it will be able to get off revenues from that, feeding that line to the South to put back into the communications for the North to help the companies.
Thank you. And our candidates from Welladay, Mark Bogan.
Thank you, Miss. Miss, I know. I'm sorry, dear. I know how you feel. I mean, for the past 15 years, people like me and families like mine have tried to get stuff going to improve our quality of life, and you know, we haven't really been heard, and it doesn't feel very good. So what I'm proposing is to bring in some programs with a proven track record and to clean up the civil justice system, saving people like you $40 to $60 million a year. I think that this is probably enough money to put a fiber link up the Mackenzie River, and that's would be one area that these savings could be used for. There's so many people like you that are out there asking for something to be done regarding their issues, and it's usually at the end of the day that there's just no money. So that's really what I propose is some spending cuts.
All right, thank you. And voting candidate Bob Bowman.
Yeah, thank you, Nancy. Good question. There's so many aspects to economic development that we haven't had a chance to discuss and we can't in a forum like this, but I'm most interested in an economy that values life over money, and that's a challenge because we don't do that typically. Digital capacity can certainly help with that. It can work towards equitability, for example, which is an important aspect to me of success in achieving healthy families and communities. So I would certainly support that. GNWP has started an economic feasibility study, a fiber link down the Mackenzie Valley, which I have supported, and I would certainly be prepared to strongly support that in the future. As I say, there's many aspects beyond equitability. It can contribute to social justice, economic diversification, all these aspects, some of which you mentioned there, green economy for sure is in line with that sort of approach.
All right, thank you.